A Triad football player is getting to continue his collegiate career at his dream school. Jacob Roberts was a standout linebacker at North Carolina A&T, finishing with 218 tackles along with 9.5 sacks in 32 games with the Aggies. Roberts entered the transfer portal in the offseason with the hope of playing in a Power 5 conference. He got that chance and is staying in the Triad, suiting up for Wake Forest.
I always dreamed about it since a little kid, you know, growing up. And seeing all my friends go from high school, you know, one day, you know, I wanted to play in a Power 5 conference, and to come here in my dream school, Wake Forest, you know, it's just a dream come true. I'm always playing with a chip on my shoulder. Middle school I got cut, high school I got cut. So, you know, I always had that chip on my shoulder, and every time I step out of the field, you know, I'm going to play like I'm the best linebacker in the nation.
Well, he's very experienced, and he was a highly productive player, and we've had a lot of success with bringing guys from the FCS level, with Ryan Smenda graduating. We wanted to get a Mike linebacker that we thought could contribute. And again, he had a great career at North Carolina A&T. He has a knack for blocking kicks. I think he blocked 9 punts. And he's just a good football player and a good person that we thought was not just a fit for our defense, but a fit for our locker room.
They said me fitting in great. You know, I'm versatile, and I'm great on special teams, so I can do it all. So I always knew I've been a high caliber player, and I knew I could play with the best, and I'm just here. I'm feeling great. I just continue to be coachable, you know, and stand in the film room and learning from a two-year starter in Chase Jones, you know, a guy who knows it all. Once I got the opportunity and got the offer, and I wanted to get my master's too, so it means a lot to get your master's from Wake Forest. So I had the best of both worlds, and God gave me the opportunity to come here, and I had to make it happen.
And Wake Forest football fans can get their first glimpse of Roberts and the Demon Deacons in just a couple of weeks. Wake Forest will hold their annual spring game April 15th at Truist Field. I love what he said about working and playing with a chip on his shoulder. Uh-huh. I think sometimes the best players are those who have something to prove. He said he got cut in middle school, he got cut in high school, and now look at him.
I think also this story shows like persistence, and when you keep working towards something, anything can happen, and that there's not one way to get to where you want to be. You don't have to do it the traditional way. There's other ways to get it done. You just have to stay focused.
And sometimes coaches, they love those guys that are hungry for it and that know that they were kind of on the edge of maybe making that. Sometimes they're more hungry than the players that are going to be playing at D1 level.
He said, I'm going to play like I'm the best player in the nation. And I think that kind of attitude, it really does go a long way.
It reminds me of Ricky Prohl when you talk to him about his career. He wasn't a superstar, you know, but he was the dependable, always there, kind of the maybe the third choice or whatever, but coaches all loved him because they said he hustled more than some of the stars would.
And how great for him to be able to play for a Wake Forest team that really is trending upward in talent. I mean, boy, last year was an impressive year. And then the fact that they had so many scouts on campus, what was it, last week, ahead of the draft, this is going to be great.
It's big.
Props to him.
We'll watch for him. We're coming right back.